24 years old from Oakland, California. I'm an actor, a student, and I work hard. I am a theater major and I love the theater. Theater is what I do. If I'm not out singing or going to live music or seeing a local play, I'm at home watching a sports game or something of that, you know. Something that inspires me, what inspires me is I never knew I really liked theater or had a love for theater until I got into college. And that is what made me really just open up and expand my mind in so many different ways. So I started to see things differently from watching movies and plays and other series that were on television. So that's pretty much my inspiration. What keeps me motivated is pretty much knowing what I've done and what's to come in the future and the different connections that I make through, you know, doing different plays and local plays, so yeah. High self-esteem is something that you feel inside first, I think. You have to feel inside if you feel beautiful, if you feel like you are phenomenal, which you are, and it will reveal on the outside. So your confidence comes from within first, and then everything else shows on the outside. So. My worth is not determined by the price of my clothes. I think it's important to have high self-esteem in a relationship because if you do not love yourself, they will find that unattractive. And that's how you know somebody can use you too. So if they see that you're not loving yourself, they might try to take advantage of you and, you know, have control of you like a puppet. And no, ladies, we are not that. So love yourself, and that person who really genuinely loves you, they will see that you love yourself and you will have a healthy relationship. So I think that's something that's important. I feel like I do have high self-esteem most of the time. There are times when I judge myself and I look at myself and I'm like, could I be something better or something more? And then at the end of the day, I feel like I made this way for a reason. So I just learned to love myself and love my flaws and just accept it and embrace it and just show it to the world. So I think my high self-esteem is a good percentage. Elementary school, I realized that I was taller than everybody, so I never was like, wanted to be around everybody because I was just like towering over them, like, hi, wanna play? So I think that was the first thing that I noticed. And then as I got older, I just saw that I had a lot of friends who were light-skinned, and I never really like thought, I was like, oh, the token dark-skinned friend that's always with them. And then there came a time when it came to like my size and everything, and I just felt like, if I'm not happy, I need to do something about it. And then as I grew older, I just began to like look in the mirror, like really take the time to look at every detail in my face and my body and just see that I am beautiful and I'm created this way to be inspiration to other people. Because if I can't do anything about it, then you have to just live with yourself and love yourself and just be some kind of encouragement or motivation for other women who go through the same thing I do. And if I can change it, then change it. But if you're happy with yourself, you know, just embrace it and love it. I am created to be something great. And I know that now, and I still might have my moments, but I have to remind myself and look myself in the eyes and say I'm beautiful because I am. Look yourself in the mirror and honestly understand that each part of your face, your eyes, your cheekbones, your the sculpture, everything that is you, understand that you are created to be something great. That you are created to be a creator and you are molded just for someone. There's always someone out there for you, but you have to love yourself first and understand that you are who you are for a reason. Whatever it is that you want to do or become, do it. go for it. Because no matter who is around you that you think may be your friend or might be, you know, if they see something that they want and they might want it more than you, they're gonna go for it. And then you're gonna sit there with regret wishing that you could have done that. So go out and fight for what it is that you want, because you never know what could happen. Once again, I'm Rolanda Bell, and thank you for taking a sec to watch my video. I would also like to appreciate your participation in the Pink Panther Self-Esteem Challenge. You can find me on Facebook or Instagram at RolandaDene. Follow me, I'll follow you back, I promise. Something's gotta change. Don't be offended, this is all my opinion. Ain't nothing that I'm saying, Lord. This is a true confession of a life learned lesson. I was sent here to share with y'all.